Good morning. In the earlier lecture, we talked about properties of moduli of complex numbers, and we studied these properties for product, division, addition, as well as subtraction. The next article is properties of arguments of complex numbers. Next article, properties of arguments of complex numbers. In this article, we have to talk about two different points: properties of arguments of complex numbers when we take product of two or more complex numbers. The second point about properties of arguments of complex numbers when we take division or quotient of complex numbers. Let us go to the first one. Arguments. The first property. Argument of product of two complex numbers is equal to sum of their arguments. Argument of product of two complex numbers is equal to sum of their arguments. To verify this property, let us consider two complex numbers Z1. We want to verify the first property of arguments, that is argument of product of two complex numbers is equal to sum of their arguments. To verify this property, we have taken two complex numbers. First complex number Z1 given by x1 plus iy1, rectangular form r1 into in the bracket cos theta 1 plus I sin theta 1, polar form is equal to r1 into e to the power I theta 1 exponential form. Second complex number z2 is equal to x2 comma y2, an ordered pair of real variables x2 y2 is equal to x2 plus i y2 rectangular form is equal to r2 into cos theta 2 plus I sin theta 2, polar form is equal to r2 e to the power I theta 2 exponential form. Now let us take product of these two. Product of complex number Z1 and complex number Z2 is Z. Product of complex numbers Z1 and Z2 is a complex number Z. And that is what? R1 e to the power I theta 1 into R2 e to the power I theta 2. Z1 R1 e to the power I theta 1 into R2 e to the power I theta 2. You may have here x1 plus iy1, here x2 plus iy2. You may have here r1 into here cos theta 1 plus I sin theta 1, here cos theta 2 plus I sin theta 2. The result will come same. This is for the equal to R1, R2, base is same, add the exponent. I can be taken common and you will have here I theta 1 plus theta 2. That is nothing but R1, R2 into in the bracket cos theta 1 plus theta 2 plus I sin theta 1 plus theta 2. Z is equal to Z1 into Z2 is equal to this. You may write this as equation number 3, this as equation number 4. Now, we have made definition of argument of a complex number while talking about the Argand plane, Argand diagram, complex plane, Gaussian plane. I want to take argument of product of Z1, Z2. That will be what? Argument of Z. But what is Z from this equation, Z1, Z2? Argument of Z1 into Z2, that is equal to. What is the argument? Theta 1 plus theta 2. Theta 1 plus theta 2. That is nothing but theta 1 plus theta 2. What is theta 1? Theta 1 is argument of Z1 plus. What is theta 2? Argument of Z2. Have a close look into equation 5. If we have a close look into equation 5, what we find? Argument of product of two complex numbers is equal to sum of their arguments. Argument of product of two complex numbers is equal to sum of their arguments. So, first property of argument of complex numbers is verified. First property of argument of complex numbers is verified. And what is that? Argument of product of two complex numbers is always equal to sum of their arguments. Hope you got it. After having discussed about the first property of arguments, when we go for product of two complex numbers, let us discuss the second property. Second property of arguments of complex numbers. To study second property of argument of complex numbers, let us consider two complex numbers, Z1 given by equation 1, Z2 given by equation 2. Now, what is the second property? Second property of arguments is argument of division or quotient of two complex numbers is equal to difference of their arguments. Argument of quotient or division of two complex numbers is equal to difference of their arguments. So, after having complex number Z1, complex number Z2, let us find division of these two complex numbers, Z1 divided by Z2. Complex number Z1 divided by complex number Z2 is a complex number Z. put your values of Z1 and Z2. Put here values of, this is for Z1 divided by, this is for Z2. This is division, Z1 divided by Z2. Here R1 divided by R2. This e to the power I theta from denominator can be taken to the numerator. It will become minus. So when I is taken common, sign coming here will be minus sign. And further here, Z is equal to Z1 divided by Z2 is equal to R1 divided by R2. What sign will come here? Minus. What sign will come here? Minus. Argument of Z is argument of Z1 divided by Z2. What sign will come here? Minus. What sign will come here? Minus. To study second property of arguments, we have considered two complex numbers, Z1 equation number 1, Z2 equation number 2 in all the forms. Then here we have done the division, Z is equal to Z1 by Z2, that is Z1 divided by Z2, that is R1 divided by R2 into e to the power I theta 1 minus theta 2. This can be further R1 by R2 into in the square bracket cos theta 1 minus theta 2 plus I sin theta 1 minus theta 2. Equation number 4, equation number 3. Take argument of Z. Argument of Z is argument of Z1 by Z2. Argument of Z1 by Z2. That is what? Theta 1 minus theta 2. What is theta 1? Argument of Z1 minus. What is theta 2? Argument of Z2. What is meaning of equation 5? Argument of division or quotient of two complex numbers is equal to difference of their arguments. Argument of quotient of two complex numbers. Argument of quotient or division of two complex numbers is always equal to difference of their arguments. This is about properties of arguments of complex numbers. Hope you got it. It is very simple and a small article. Thank you.